Good morning, good afternoon, good evening. Can you all hear me? Okay, you can hear me. Thank you. There was a snarky person in the next room who claimed that I could not be heard. He should shut the door. All right, yeah, you're not going to be able to see me, but you are going to be able to hear me as we go through. As we go through everything, I now have my peanut gallery sequestered in another room. I am Jacqueline Ashwell, organizer of the 24th Annual Interactive Fiction Competition. This has been my first year at the helm, and it has been super fun to hang out with authors and judges, and you all have been really nice to me. So thanks for that. Before we begin, I've got a little secret to admit to you all. The idea of doing this as a live stream, it came up pretty recently. Like Thursday night as I was watching the ballot box close. So, a few things. First, the idea of this event, it's less than 48 hours old. So, please all continue to be nice to me. That said, before year's end, we will conduct a survey, as we do every year, about this year's competition to include how we presented the results today. And I'm looking forward to your feedback on this and on ideas that you might have for the future. There's going to be a little bit of a delay on the chat bar, so I'll try and go a little slowly to catch any questions that you might have and that sort of thing. I wanted to also share that I did not realize until after I announced that I was going to do this on Twitch how many interesting author names and game titles there were this year, and I tried to do my due diligence learning how to pronounce everything, but if I mess something up or I leave anybody out or anything like that, please do forgive me. If you or we encounter any technical issues, like JJ Guest appears to be having right now, bandwidth problems, whatever, do not worry. This is being locally recorded, and I will post a link to the broadcast later on today. Is there a lot of pop on the recording? How's that? I'll move my mic away. The pop better? Pop, pop, pop. Okay, great. Thank you. And finally, I did ask for volunteers to mod today's chat, but I couldn't get any takers on such short notice. So please, just be excellent to each other. Remember that this is being recorded, and remember that IFComp always strives to provide a safe and welcoming environment to interactive fiction creators and players of every kind. So participants who personally harass other participants, and that includes today's stream, can be banned from further participation in the comp, so let's not have to go there. All right, let's get started. First off, I'd like to do some thank yous to everybody who made this year another success. Authors, judges, prize donors, people who boosted us on social media. In particular, I'd like to give a shout out to all the people who make this competition so much easier to run. Thanks to the Interactive Fiction Technology Foundation, they are a charitable nonprofit who's publicly funded, publicly provided funds, I should say, and volunteer effort really helped make IFComp and lots of other cool IF endeavors possible. And the IFComp committee. These folks volunteer to join me for monthly, sometimes weekly, meetings to help keep the competition on track, provide advice, generate new ideas. They are absolute rock stars, and I appreciate them so, so much. I'd also like to thank a small and new committee that we formed this year, the IFComp Outreach Committee. Thanks in large part to Liza and Victor and David. We shifted our focus this year from trying to find more authors and instead seeking out more judges. After all, judging is really the best way to get started with this competition, and lots of judges turn into future authors. So thanks, Liza, Victor, David, your efforts paid off. We actually had 247 judges this year, which is up from last year's record of 213. Super nice. So thank you, outreach team. Thomas Mack joined us this year as prize coordinator. He's been tracking everybody's awesome prize donations, and soon we'll be working with authors to distribute all that cool stuff. Thank you, Thomas. Thanks to everybody who contributed prizes. And if you're curious about the prize list, it's listed on our website. And Andrew Plotkin, in addition to being a critical member of the IFComp committee, served for the second year as the manager of the Colossal Fund. So thanks to him and to all of you who contributed this year. We raised $9,000. $9,000. The majority of those funds raised are going to go to authors. So this year, it's two-thirds of the crop, so 51 authors will be eligible for prizes. And the top prize this year is $395.85, which is quite the prize. And the bottom prize is $10.04. So there you go. The rest goes towards support for the IFComp and other great endeavors of the Interactive Fiction Technology Foundation. I'd like to give a special thanks to Lyne Hollis, who is our competition curator. That is a huge job. Lyne reviews every entry prior to the competition and makes sure that every single game adheres to the competition rules and that hopefully it will not fry your system when you launch it. So thanks a lot for that, Lyne. And Mark Mizante really kicked it up this year in his support of the web application, and he's already got great ideas for making the site even better in 2019. So thank you, Mark. And of course, extra special thanks to Jason McIntosh, who stayed on as the IFComp technical lead this year. He maintains the web application, which has a ton of bells and whistles to keep track of. And really, more than anything, he did an excellent job this year of sharing his experience as a prior organizer from the past 4 years, yet he very much allowed me to take the full reins, and I just appreciate you, Jason. So thanks so much. All right. So I saw your joke, whoever it was in the peanut gallery, that said, IFComp, more like WhenComp. I guess let's get started. First off, we've got a couple of fun side contests that we run every year. You guys are probably familiar with that, but for those who aren't, we have the Golden Banana of Discord. So this is awarded to a game with the largest standard deviation. Or to put it another way, this award recognizes the entry with the most disagreement among everybody who rated it. So think of it as recognizing quality via critical division or something. So this year, I'm not going to go quite to that yet. Let me give you some history. The banana, I found this interesting. It was originally just a normal prize. In 2000, it was chosen by Brendan Barnwell, author of The Big Mama, and Brendan redonated the banana with this fun whole standard deviation idea. And there is a physical banana. Winners of the banana are expected to redonate it back to the competition the following year. So unless the banana goes AWOL again, this year's winner will be able to display the banana, which is not a real banana, for the next year in the comfort of their home without attracting any like fruit flies or anything. This year's game had a standard deviation of 2.64. I'm just watching you all in the chat. Guess it. Who's the winner? The 2018 Golden Banana of Discord goes to Tohu Vabohu by Alex Wesley Moore. Congrats, Alex. All right, so next up, next side contest. Miss Congeniality. So these are the top three IFComp entries according to ballots cast by the authors who participated in this year's competition. Third place, according to fellow authors, Boogeyman by Elizabeth Smith. Thank you, Emily. I appreciate that too. I appreciate your appreciation. In second place, according to fellow authors, Junior Arithmancer by Mike Spivey. Woo! Those of you on the IFComp committee who are secretly kibitzing behind the scenes on Slack, your updates are coming up on my phone as I talk. And I did think about doing some sound, like sound effects or something, but I thought maybe that would be too cheesy. What do you all think? Should I do sound effects next year? Should I have background music? I tried to find background music. I'll be interested for your feedback, everybody. But enough about that. You're probably kind of curious about first place, according to fellow authors, the first place Miss Congeniality Award 2018, Alias the Magpie by JJ Guest. I hope JJ Guest is actually able to see the stream at this point. JJ, you have anything you want to say? He's still not on the stream. Oh no. People tell him what he's won. Give JJ one more second to see if he wants to say anything. Okay. So now, on to the 2018 Interactive Fiction Competition Top 10. You know, it should be noted that we had another really large number of games this year, and the top 15 games had a score of 7 or better, which is just awesome. So, if you haven't played all the entries, there are a lot of new games out there. In fact, here are the votes by score. We had 4,187 votes. That's a lot of votes, so thank you everybody for playing and voting and leaving feedback. Again, the competition couldn't happen without all of you judges. Tenth place. We join Sandra as she investigates what happened to her deep space mining facility. Lux by Agnieszka Trzaska. Agnieszka, are you here? Would you like to say anything? Looks like Agnieszka might not be here. Right. That having been said, we shall move on. Ninth place. An ambitious and inventive game. Atmospheric and absolutely packed with layers of content. People are still trying to peel apart this onion. Cannery Vale by Kanan Connor, who is also known as, better known as, Kanan Andrysik. Congrats, Kanan, are you on? Did I pronounce your name anywhere close to correctly? All right, eighth place. This is a beautifully illustrated Rabbit Odyssey. Yours by Christopher Hayes and Daniel Talsky. I feel like I should have some sort of a little button I push that has like a cheering track. Doug Orleans, I gotta tell you, I didn't pronounce Hannon's name that way either until I decided to do this broadcast, and I spent a lot of time with some of these names, like listening to YouTube videos of how to pronounce these sorts of things. There's a lot of websites out there that help you, so if I'm wildly off, that's why. Right. Seventh. Place. If you like math and you like puzzles, and there was my pop filter, if you like puzzles, then this might be the game for you. Junior Arithmancer by Mike Spivey. All right, sixth place. Parties, power, paranoia, ghosts, and dancers in a maze of stories. The Master of the Land by Sue David. Sorry, Roger, there is actually a chart out there that tells how much every person is getting. I do not have that in front of me right now. Zarf is on and wants to add that stuff in, he can. Right. And now that you know what that means, we are at the top five. It's really exciting. Okay, in fifth place, you are a ghost, piecing together the clues of your demise in Erstwhile by Matty Fiala and Mariska Perry. Congratulations. Fourth place. This one is a mystery game. Seven main cases, multiple endings, and an inordinate amount of whiskey. Grimoire by Propi. Right. Now, the top three. Dun, dun, dun. Third place, the story of Charlie Stewart, 9-year-old human child, who is really just four critters in a kid's suit. Animalia by Ian Michael Waddell. And Michael, if I mispronounced your, or Ian rather, if I mispronounced your name, please let me know. Congratulations. So I know you're here. Do you want to say anything? It'd be interesting perhaps next year, although it would mean revealing to the authors ahead of time that they won, but to be able to have them on the feed verbal. If people would like that, let me know. Maybe we can figure that out for next year. That means that we are in the top two. Top two, top two. I'm so excited. Okay. In second place, a score of 7.82, 5 votes. Go home. Boogeyman, Elizabeth Smith. Congratulations. Elizabeth, are you here today? Okay, it looks like Elizabeth is not with us today, but congratulations, Elizabeth. We are very, very proud of you. And here it is, the moment you've been waiting for. First place, the score of 8.276 votes, it appears that the judges agreed with the authors about this year's top game, the hilarious madcap exploits of Sir Rodney Playfair, Gentleman Thief, the winner of the 24th annual interactive fiction competition, who I think is still not able to see the stream, but everybody's talking to him, Alias the Magpie, JJ Guest. And that is it for our event today, folks. Thank you again to all the authors and the donors and the volunteers and the judges and everybody. Feel free to hang out and chat with friends. I'll leave the stream open. I'll stick around for a bit as well. And of course, I encourage you to hit our website to play anything that looked interesting to you today that you hadn't gotten to yet. You can also give us feedback on today's event via Twitter at IFComp or by email at IFComp@IFComp.org. Thank you so much, everyone.